Hello children, I am Adita ma'am. Today I am going to take class 5th computer science lesson number 1. Before I start, I would like to start with the word of God. Grace, mercy and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. Children, Lord is saying that His mercy, His peace, His grace will be always there if you believe in Him, have faith in Him. I also pray to God that we all should receive His grace, His peace and mercy during this hard days. Amen. Yes, today we are going to start the first lesson, that is evolutions of computers. So what is computer? As we all know that computer is an electronic machine that processes and stores information. It manipulates the data accurately, efficiently and faster than a human brain. It processes a set of instructions given by the user to give a certain output. Now we will go through evolutions of computers. Modern days computer has a long history of evolution. It is more efficient and occupies a fraction of space that conventional computers. Early computers used mechanical relays and vacuum tubes, which were replaced by transistors and later by integrated circuits, which led to the microprocessor we use it today. Yes, in the previous slide we went through the evolution of computer. Now we will just go through some histories of the computers in detail. First one is abacus. Before the generation of the computer came, various histories were there. So we will go through it. First one is abacus. Abacus was invented by a Chinese inventor. It was the first computing device used by the human. Abacus had a wooden frame with vertical rod. The frame was divided into two parts, the heaven and the earth. Each rod in heaven has two wheels and each rod in earth has five wheels. It helped to add, subtract, multiply and divide. And on those days, the shopkeepers were using this abacus for doing the calculation. Now the second history is Neffer's bones. In 1617, John Neffer, a Scottish mathematician and physicist, devised a set of rods that were used for multiplication. These rods had numbers written on them. The rods could be carved out of bones, metals, wood or ivory. After the name of the scientist, this device was popularly known as Neffer's bone. You can see in the image, the second one is the Neffer's bones. The third history is Pascalian calculator. A French mathematician, Blaise Pascal, devised a computing device called Pascalian calculator. It used gears, dials and series of rotating numbers wheel. The Pascalian calculator could perform addition and subtraction only. Also, it was widely used for accounting purpose. The first Pascalian was capable to perform 5-digit number calculation. Then the advanced series came. After that, it calculated 6 to 8-digit numbers. The image is given on the slide. And the last one was difference engine and analytic engine. Difference engine. In 1822, Charles Babbage invented the difference engine. It was the first automatic calculator. It was capable to perform mathematical calculation automatically. And in 1837, Charles Babbage also devised analytic engine. It was a mechanical computer that was capable to perform complex mathematical calculation like multiple and division. The base of this device was similar to the simple computer system. It had 5 units: input, store, mill, control and output. Yes, just now we went through the history of computers. Okay, so how many histories were there? Abacus, Nicholas Bones, Pascaline calculator, difference engine, analytic engine. Now we will go through generations of computer. Advancement in computers required speed, accuracy, instant results. The development of modern day computer is classified into different generations. The base of the such calculations were speed, reliability, storage, technology and cost. Yes, now we will go through the generations of computers. The first generations of computers were in the year of 1940 to 1958. In this, features of first generation computer was that they used vacuum tubes. And the second feature was the magnetic drum for the memory. And this generation computer was very large but very less storage capacity and was slow and consumed a lot of energy. Now we will go to the second generation of computer. The second generation of computers came in the year 1959 to 1963. As we know, in the first generation they used vacuum tube, but in the second generation they replaced vacuum tubes with transistors. Transistors were smaller, cheaper and more reliable in use than vacuum tubes. The second generation computer used punch cards and magnetic tapes for input and output purpose. They were more efficient and economical. They could calculate data in seconds. Now we will go to the third generation computers. The third generation computers came in the year 1964 to 1970. The third generation computer incorporated integrated circuits, or we can say ICs. And integrated circuits named as it house a large number of transistors in it. It is also known as chip. In these computers, keyboard and monitors were used for input and output purpose. The third generation computer were even faster, highly economical and more reliable than the earlier generation computers. Now we will go to the fourth generation computers. It came in the year of 1971 and till now it is processing. The main feature of fourth generation computer is use for the microprocessor. Microprocessor is the entire CPU on a single chip. VLSI stands for Very Large Scale Integrated Circuit. In such circuit, a single chip may contain a large number of ICs. So this generation computers use input devices such as keyboard, mouse, scanners, etc. And output devices include speakers, printers, monitors, etc. Now we go with the fifth generation of computer. The present and the beyond one is the fifth generation of computer. The fifth generation of computer used ULCI, that is ultra large scale integration. Another important of these features of computers are the introduction of artificial intelligence, that is developing thinking power of computer and make it do things like human do. For example, reorganizing voice, making decisions, translation of different languages, etc. In this generation, the most remarkable invention is the supercomputer. So these are the five generations of computer. Yes, till now we went through the generations of computers. Now we will go through the different types of computers. Yes, computer can be classified based on the size, technology and purpose for which they are used. There are four types of computers. They are microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe computers and supercomputers. Just now we went through the different generations and types of computers. We know there are four types of computer. First one is microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe computers and supercomputers. So we will go through the first one, that is microcomputers. Example is, it is a single user and it is called as PC, personal computers, and it is cheapest in all, not bulky, single chip is contained in that. Examples of various microcomputers are desktop, laptop and pamtop. Yes, the next one is mini computers. Mini computers were developed in 1960s. They were more powerful than microcomputers, but they were expensive and less flexible. In contrast to microcomputers, multi-users can operate a mini computer at once. Mini computers use transistors and core memory technologies, large storage capacities. They can function as network and internet server. They were mostly used in a small business firms. You can see the image of mini computer in the slide. Yes, the next one is mainframe computers. Mainframe computers are high powered large computers. These computers are capable to perform billions of calculations and multiple sources. Therefore, a large number of people can use mainframe computers simultaneously. So, one mainframe computer can connect people across the world. Usually, mainframe computers are used in banks, universities, government organizations, and multiple users can share data and information. You can see the image of mainframe computer also. Yes, now we will just go through the supercomputers. The first supercomputer was developed by Control Data Corporation in the year 1960s. Supercomputers are the most powerful and most expensive of all the four types of computers. They are capable for processing millions of instructions in a second. They are used in specialized fields that requires complex mathematical calculations, such as in nuclear energy research, exploration of petroleum, weather forecasting, etc. Yes, children, till now we went through different topics in this lesson: evolution of computers, history of computers, generations of computers, types of computers. Now we are going to understand about limitations of computer. As we know, the computer can only perform tasks as you ask to it. The computer cannot generate information by itself. If you give computer wrong data, it is going to give you wrong information. Computer are unable to correct wrong instructions. Few more things to understand. Illegal hacking and cracking provokes computer crimes. Hackers and crackers steal and misuse the important information of many organizations, institutes and individual people. Many times we give our personal information like address, phone number, account number, etc. for many online forms like net banking, email accounts, registration, etc. Such data is not protected properly, the privacy of a person can be violated. Prolonged and improper use of computer may result in poor posture, deformation of your hands, eyes, necks, wrist, elbows and backbone. So it is necessary to sit in a proper posture while working on computer and also take regular breaks after every 30 minutes. Created waste from the computer manufacturing process and by the users are polluting our environment by generating e-waste. The parts of the computers contain toxic substance released into the environment and pollute it. Recycling and proper regulation of manufacturing processes guidelines may help to overcome such problems, such as e-waste should be disposed of properly. So these are some limitations of the computer. Yes, in this image, just to recap what you studied, first one is what is computer, second is characteristics and the limitations of the computers. It is given over there in the image, what is computer as well as the characteristics of the computers. So I hope you understood this lesson. Read the chapter nicely. Try to solve the exercises with the pencils in your book. I hope you wrote the question answer of this lesson. If not, please do inform so that I can send the question answers Yes. I hope you understood this lesson. As I said before, read the chapter nicely. Try to solve the exercises of the lesson. If you read the chapter nicely, you can solve the exercises also. I hope you wrote the question answers. So, take care of your health. Thank you. Yes, children. So, every day sit and pray to God to shower His mercy, His peace, His grace upon you and your family. We all are praying. God bless you all.